Yes,
Mr. Moyers.
Yes. Operator.
Moyers office?
Let me speak to Mr. Moyers, please.
He's working on another extension at the moment.
All right, can I hold this, President?
Yes, sir. One moment.
Well, Paul, I just might as well not have you and Kim down here.
Hello.
What do you know?
Well, things are going pretty well, I think, from the standpoint of just isolated returns. It's too early to have anything definite, but I'll give you these. Jack's probably giving the report from Molly Quayle, saying that it looks like we'll carry Kansas with 52% of the vote. Number one, there's a Republican precinct in New Jersey. The absentee ballots have gone for 344 to 250. One precinct here in Washington, D.C., a Negro precinct, it looks like it's going for us 85 to 1. John Bailey told me a few minutes ago we probably will carry, on the basis of his early return, we'll probably carry Connecticut by 500,000. Scammon says that the Kansas situation is probably the best sign you'll get, that he's got his eyes on two states, New Hampshire and Kansas. If we don't do well, and if we lose New Hampshire, we're in trouble. But if we care about even one vote, we're in very good shape. Kansas is a bellwether in this election because of the rural conservative makeup out there. This precinct in Norfolk went for 17 to nothing, and a Republican precinct in Upper Michigan that went 12 to nothing for Nixon. In 1960, has gone 7-5 for Goldwater, which means that we're picking up five of that vote. Those are basically all that we have right now. Just isolated incidents, but all of them are encouraging. Heavy turnout in our precinct in New York. I've talked to Mr. Wiseman. I've talked to Bobby Kennedy. He feels now that he'll probably carry win by at least 400,000. You'll win by 2 million. And Governor Brown, I talked to Governor Brown. He's too early out there, but the voting's very heavy, and very heavy in Democratic precincts, also heavy in Republican precincts, particularly in Orange County, as we expected. Voting is very heavy. Republican voting was very heavy this morning in Memphis, not very heavy in our precincts. Abe Portis got that report, and I got a hold of Cliff, and he's on top of that. And our people are traditionally vote, I'm told, in the afternoons in Memphis. I've got no report from Georgia yet. Carl Sanders is going to call me at 6:45 our time. Let me know what it looks like. But those are it.
What does Sanders think about Georgia? Close.
50,000, our side.
Out of how many? A million?
A little over a million. Heavy, heavy Negro turnout all throughout the South. Unusually large turnout in Virginia on both sides, Republican and Democrat. Took me 15 minutes to vote this morning at 7:30. Precincts in Bethesda and Silver Springs a mile long. There's one Republican precinct in San Antonio. Have you got that report yet?
No.
Republican precinct, Johnson 250, 260, and Goldwater 240, Yarbrough 240, and Bush 220. That's a Republican precinct in, traditionally Republican precinct in San Antonio.
What is Johnson
250, 260 to 240.
There's 20 votes lead.
20 votes. Yarbrough, 240 to 220.
Well, he's just 20.
Right.
Well, that doesn't sound good. San Antonio oughtn't have any Republican.
But I can't think of the name of that area over in San Antonio. That's a heavy Republican.
Alamo Heights,
that's right. That's right. Things ought to really start picking up in 10 minutes. About 6:30, I'm supposed to start getting calls from Bailey and others, and I'll wing them right on down there. I went by to see Walter this afternoon. First time I've been by, they told me I shouldn't go until today. He's feeling good.
What did he say?
Well, he just hopes it's a big margin because he said you've got everything at stake and he's got a lot at stake too on the size of it. He feels if it's close, it'll be his fault. If it's not, you want to spite him. But he was in good outlook. He said he and Marge are going to take off as soon as he get out of the hospital and go away for a while and think about what they ought to do. He had a number of job offers, didn't know what he would do. They would think about it when they got away. He was actually in good spirits.
Did you know we love him?
Yes, sir.
Please tell him what to do. More than anybody in the world.
I'm going to call him from time to time tonight. Check with the doctor.
Tell him we just love him more than anything in the world.
Right.
Well, I just fell apart. My back's hurting. My head's hurting. I'm aching all over. I've got a headache. I don't know what I'm going to do. I've been in bed all day long.
Well, just take it easy. I wish you'd go get some sun somewhere, Key West or something like that.
Well, I'm afraid of Vietnam. I got to hang up teleoperator to get me, Rusk.
All right.
And you call us here at the ranch. We'll be here another hour.
Right. Thank you.
All you and Ken ain't worth a damn in Delaware and Iowa. How much do you bet on Delaware?
Yeah,
I don't know. William being defeated?
All right.